So my gay friend was telling me about his first homoerotic dream, and it happened shortly after a traumatic event. He was beaten up in middle school by a bully, and I've talked to many of my male and female homosexual friends, and all of their homosexual desires started shortly after a traumatic event in their life. And this syncs up perfectly with the work of Dr. Homer. He was a German doctor, and he was armed with that German precision, and he interviewed thousands of homosexuals, and he looked at all of their brain CT scans. And 100% of the time, if he was looking at a homosexual, their CT scans would have a sharp ring in the right temporal lobe and another sharp ring in the left temporal lobe 100% of the time. Now, I'm not trying to offend anybody in this video. I am honestly trying to help people because when someone first starts getting these homosexual thoughts for the same sex, it can be a very scary experience because they don't know how their friends and family are going to react. There are some countries where you face the death penalty for being a homosexual. And you know, some people might think that they're broken or there's something wrong with them or that they're a sinner. And you know, I don't want anyone to have to go through this. And we tend to fear what we don't understand, but luckily for us, Dr. Homer has done all of the work, all of the research for us, and he kind of maps out how someone becomes a homosexual and you know what that means for us. Homosexuality is actually very common, you know, out in Mother Nature. It's everywhere. So maybe you're curious about how you became a homosexual. Maybe you have a friend or a family member that just came out, or maybe you're just curious and want to learn more about this topic. So some other things we're going to talk about in this video is, are you at risk for becoming a homosexual? Can you turn off homosexuality? Are there health consequences for being a homosexual? And how did these mysterious rings form in the brain? I will answer all these questions and more, supported by evidence-based research and personal experiences. Hi, I'm Mike the Healer Gut Guy. I healed myself and many others naturally of Crohn's, colitis, IBS, IBD, and all sorts of other gut issues. And we do this by addressing the root cause with the help of German New Medicine. No boring diets and no dangerous drugs needed. You know, people die every day of these gut issues, and that is why you need to enroll in my rapid gut healing program because we are the only program that addresses the root cause. My program has over 20 hours of educational videos. It comes with a private Facebook group where me and my other two coaches who have healed themselves naturally of gut issues and have helped many other people just like you do the same, we answer your questions every single day. And 3 times a week, you can get on a live video chat with us and ask us anything you want. We'll answer all of your questions. This will save you thousands of dollars on other treatments that don't address the root cause or are even aware of the root cause of your gut issues. It also comes with a 90-day money-back guarantee. Right now, it is $497 or 6 monthly payments of $97, but I need to increase this price soon because inflation has just been crazy these past couple of years. But if you can't buy my program right now, that is okay. You can use my free 30-day program, or you could just watch my free YouTube videos. I've seen plenty of people get better with that information there. So, how did my friend become gay? So, here is his brain. Before any conflict shots, it is a clean slate. And his first conflict shock happened at a young age. Now, remember, he is young, he doesn't know better. He had just moved into a new neighborhood, he had no friends, and one of the neighborhood boys showed him how to please him orally, and they would take turns pleasing each other orally. Now, this might seem like, oh, He was gay from the get-go, but this is actually more normal than you would think. Most young males go through a homoerotic episode, and I foster kittens. Me and my wife foster kittens, and when the sexual organs start to develop, I mean, they are unbearable. They hump everything. They'll hump your shoe, your leg, your arm, your face. Whether you're a male or a female, they don't care. And so for young boys to be left unattended, it is expected for these types of behaviors to develop if left unchecked. But this, so what happened is one of his siblings found out about this, that this was going on, and they went and they told mom and dad, and that was the conflict shock, because he got into real big trouble with his family, and he kind of felt like an outsider, like he had lost his family. So he is a right-handed female, so a ring would appear on the right temporal lobe here. Now, this has many health consequences, but it is beyond the scope of this video. But one thing we can talk about is testosterone production is controlled in the right temporal lobe. So if we have a conflict shock in the right temporal lobe, this hurts testosterone production. The testosterone goes down and he becomes more feminine in his personality and in his physical appearance. And he will also, his next territorial conflict shock that he experiences will be from a more feminine perspective. So his first conflict shock is a territorial loss. He's losing his territory, his family. But his second conflict shock is going to be experienced from a female perspective, which is going to be a sexual conflict. So a few years later, before he fully went through puberty, he was attracted to a woman and pursuing this girl in his class, and her boyfriend found out about it and beat him up. He suffered this as a sexual conflict. I can't mate with this girl that I like. And so a ring appeared here in the left temporal lobe. So in German New Medicine, when we have these two conflicts in the temporal lobes, we call this a maturity stop, and it has to happen before puberty. I have this as well. I look very young for my age. I am 34, but this happened to me after puberty, and you know, my conflicts weren't as intense and prolonged, so I'm not a homosexual. I am straight. So for someone to become a homosexual, they have to have a maturity stop before puberty, and a maturity stop is two conflicts in the temporal lobes. The temporal lobes are the newest part of the brain, and they have to do with, it's the most advanced part of the brain. It has to do with our social contracts. So our relationships with our friends, our family, and whatnot, and social groups. And we call them territorial conflicts, and they can be experienced from either a masculine or a feminine point of view, depending on someone's hormone status. Now, it is beyond the scope of this video to go over the health consequences of each and every one of these brain relays that we're looking at here. But if you want to learn more, you can go to learninggnm.com and learn this for free. But if you want my help and my coach's help to help you understand this, you can do that inside of our rapid gut healing program. The link for that is down below. So another example is from my homosexual female friend. When she was 10 and 12, she was attacked by a pedophile. She is a right-handed female, and so this affected her as a sexual conflict, and a ring formed in her brain on the left temporal lobe. Now, the consequences of this is lower estrogen production. The left temporal lobe is responsible for estrogen production in the brain, and this conflict will decrease the estrogen production, which causes her to experience her next conflict involving a territorial conflict is going to be from a more masculine perspective. So she didn't first start developing her attraction towards females. She had boyfriends during the time between the two conflict shocks. So she really started to develop attraction for the same sex during a time she called the worst 2 years of her life. So she moved schools in high school, and then in this new high school she had zero friends, and she was picked on. She was absolutely miserable, and she experienced this from a masculine point of view as a territorial loss in a ring formed in the right temporal lobe, which formed the maturity stop, and her attraction for women developed from there. You know, this is also called, when someone has two hard rings in their temporal lobes like this, this is also called a post-mortal constellation, and where people experience suicidal thoughts. And she was very suicidal during this time. So another example is from a right-handed male. He was bullied a lot when he was younger by his brothers and friends and stuff like that. So at some point he suffered a territorial loss. Boom, ring in the right temporal lobe. This hurts testosterone production, makes him more feminine. So his second conflict was in high school, and he had this huge crush on this blue-eyed, beautiful, blonde-haired girl who rejected him. And this broke his heart, and he experienced it as a sexual conflict, which completed the maturity stop. And that is when his homosexual urges, and that's when he started to pursue relationship with men. So that's how things normally play out, but there's a few other variables I want to make you aware of. So normally, right-handed males are more feminine, so they will play the feminine role in the relationship, whereas left-handed males have a higher chance of being more masculine, and they'll play the masculine part of the homosexual relationship. And for females, it's going to be a little different because there's lots of things playing with a female's hormone status. I mean, you got birth control pills, you got pregnancy, so there's some things we got to look out for. But in general, left-handed females are going to be more feminine, and they're going to be the more feminine in the relationship. And then the right-handed females are going to be more masculine, and they will play the more masculine role in the relationship. I don't expect you to understand these details, but if you work with us inside the Rapid Gut Healing Program, and I can answer these questions for you, or you do more research on learninggnm.com. Are you at risk for becoming homosexual? According to Dr. Homer's work, if you are past puberty, you cannot become a homosexual. Can you cure homosexuality? Can you reverse it and become a heterosexual? And according to what Dr. Homer observed, is if you resolve these conflicts, then the person will become bisexual. But the way that I kind of see it working in my mind is, you know, our symptoms, and homosexuality is a symptom of these two conflict shocks. And the intensity of the symptoms are always dependent on the length and intensity of the conflicts. So if someone has these conflicts during puberty and they quickly get resolved, you know, they're going to be straight. But if, you know, they're off and on and intense, you know, all over the place, and, you know, are well past puberty, I mean, someone's homosexual tendencies are going to be pretty hard locked in. Are there any health side effects to being homosexual? So many homosexuals will suffer from depression, mania, and bipolar disorder. And when I say mania, like, there's being depressed, like, oh, I just can't get out of bed, I'm so sad, I can't do anything. And then there's mania, like, I have this problem, and I'm more of a manic person, and it's like I'm just gonna throw all my energy at this problem until it gets solved. Whereas a depressed person, you know, they become sad, and the survival mechanism of this is the depressed person waits for the problem to blow over, where the manic person attacks the problem head on. And someone who's bipolar, they're switching back and forth between these two modes. And the way that this happens is, you know, if someone has a conflict shock in the right side of the brain, right side of the temporal lobe, This makes them depressed. Dr. Homer saw that the more intense and sharp this ring is, the more depressed somebody was. And the more sharp that the ring was on the left temporal lobe, the more intense the conflict activity of that conflict, the more manic somebody would be. And depending on which conflict was more intense at the time would determine whether someone was depressed or whether someone was manic. And that's, and you know, so if someone has like two problems that are yo-yoing back and forth, you know, that's going to cause them to be manic and depressed, manic and depressed. So let's go back to my friend. Every time he would experience a conflict with his parents, he would become depressed because it's linked to this right temporal lobe thing. It's a territorial loss. And when he experiences some, like when he suspects that a mate isn't being faithful or, you know, he can't, you know, pursue this person for whatever reason, he would become manic. Homosexuals are also known for having a higher rate of psychological disorders. And I don't like to call them disorders because they're actually survival mechanisms, as silly as that might sound. But, you know, they have higher rates of depression, OCD, autism, and high sex drives. And this is all a result of having a different pattern of these rings in your temporal lobes. And depending on the pattern will produce a very specific type of behavior. And this is beyond the scope of this video. I could talk about this for hours, but if you want to learn more, go to learninggnm.com, or if you want me to explain it to you, I can do this for you inside of the Rapid Gut Healing Program. So a lot of religious communities and people and countries are really hard on homosexuals, and it just isn't fair. It isn't right, because homosexuality is it's almost completely random who it can happen to. It's really the luck of the draw, and it happens before puberty at a young age where we don't, you know, you don't get to choose who your parents are. You don't get to choose the environment that you grow up in, and it could happen to anybody. And it's kind of random on how our biology decides to experience these conflict shocks. You know, so God designed us, and that means that homosexuality is part of His design. And if God is a kind God, it doesn't make any sense for someone to be condemned for being a homosexual. And plus, if you are a real Christian and understand its core principle, Jesus paid for your sins. We're all sinners. And as long as you believe in Him, that He paid for your sins, then, you know, you're good. So nowhere in the Bible does it say directly that homosexuality is a sin. If we look at the Ten Commandments, it says, "Thou shalt not commit adultery," but then the word adultery isn't clearly defined. And you have to also take into account that the Bible is totally okay with having multiple wives and owning slaves. So the ethics here are extremely confusing. You know, God is supposed to be a kind and loving God, and it doesn't make sense for Him to program this into us as a survival mechanism and then condemn us for it. It doesn't make any sense. So comment down below, do you think homosexuality is a sin? Are you a homosexual? Can you remember your conflict shocks? I'm very curious to get your side of the story. You know, if you're suffering from any gut health issues, please go down below in the description and watch my 30-day plan. It is absolutely free. But if you would like to work with me and work with my other coaches, then sign up for the Rapid Gut Healing Program. Link is down in the description. I'm Mike the Heal Your Gut Guy. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.